Hi, this is Kevin Brocious. I'd like to discuss today a little bit about exchange-traded funds and how they can help clients' portfolios. The first exchange-traded fund, or ETF, appeared in the United States in 1993 when the Standard & Poor's S&P 500 Depository Receipts, the SPDR, began trading on the American Stock Exchange. Since that time, nearly 1,000 ETFs have been released with invested assets of over $1 trillion. An ETF is nothing more than an investment fund that trades like a stock on an exchange and tracks a stock market index, such as the S&P 500. They are similar to index mutual funds, which have the goal to replicate the performance of a particular market index, with a couple of notable advantages over mutual funds, including liquidity, transparency, tax efficiency, and cost. Liquidity. Where mutual funds can only be sold or purchased at the end of the trading day, ETFs can be traded at any time during the trading day. This gives the investor the flexibility in their buying and selling positions. The 2008 credit crisis should remind all of us the importance of liquidity. Transparency. The composition file of each exchange-traded fund is published daily, so investors can understand exactly where their dollars are being invested. Mutual funds have to disclose their holdings every quarter. In addition, when you purchase an ETF, you get the intraday market price. Mutual fund purchases are all priced as of the end of the trading day, regardless of time when the order was processed. Tax efficiency. ETFs are tax-efficient vehicles for taxable accounts. In most cases, when ETFs are redeemed, the ETF doesn't have to sell any of its underlying securities to pay for the redemptions. This means that the sale usually doesn't trigger a capital gain distribution to the shareholders. However, when shareholders of mutual funds redeem their shares, the mutual fund company usually has to sell held securities to fund this redemption, often resulting in capital gain distributions to holders of mutual funds. So in down markets, investors will still get hit with a tax bill even when they lost money. At the end of 2008, a lot of investment advisors had a hard time explaining to clients why their equity mutual fund investments were down 35%, but they still had to pay a capital gains tax. Cost. Studies have shown that nearly 80% of actively managed equity mutual funds underperform the average stock market return. However, the average management fee for an equity mutual fund is about 1.4% per year. This ignores additional fees for front-end or back-end loaded funds. Compare this to the SPDR S&P 500 index, which tracks the S&P index 4.1% per year. Since ETFs trade on an exchange, there will be a difference between the market price for buying an ETF, the bid, and the market price for selling an ETF, the ask price. This is called the bid-ask spread. Larger, well-capitalized ETFs usually will have a very small spread. For example, the largest ETF, the SPDR S&P 500, usually trades at about a penny difference between the bid and ask price. ETFs with less net assets and lower trading volumes, however, can trade at much greater spreads. Thanks for tuning in.